Hi, this is Jasmine from ENTTEC, and today we are going to go over the new ENTTEC feature, Custom Protocols. This feature is in the new OCTO Mark II and the new Pixelator Minis. This is only available for OCTO devices with version 4.0 or above and Pixelator Mini devices that are version 2.0 onwards. If you want to know if your OCTO or Pixelator Mini can support it, please visit our website. The link is in the description. Stay until the end because we will tell you what to look out for if your controller isn't using the correct protocol for quick troubleshooting. Before we dive right in, if you want to hear more tips and tricks or just want to stay up to date with ENTTEC news and products and be notified when we go live, then hit that subscribe button and the bell so you don't miss a thing. Have you ever been working on a project and you wired up your lights only to find out the controller you were using doesn't support your lights protocol? In the past, you used to have to contact the controller manufacturer and request an update to support your lights. Well, no more. With Custom Protocol, you can control almost any LED lights from your device. This video will show you how, with the OCTO Mark II and the new Pixelator Mini, how you can customize your own protocols and control almost any LED strip. Quick disclaimer, for this to work, your lights have to comply with two key criteria to be eligible for custom protocols: data structure and data transmission method. We don't want to bore you with a long explanation of each in this video, so we have created a custom protocol creation guide which goes through all of the technical information. The link is in the description. Okay, so I'm going to assume that you have read the informational document and your lights meet the two criteria for custom protocols. Now, we can go through how to customize your protocols, and for this example, we are going to use the OCTO Mark II. But you can do the same for your new Pixelator Mini. For this, you just need a computer or smartphone with an internet browser that is on the same local network as your OCTO Mark II, the OCTO Mark II's IP address, the data sheet of your lighting fixture, and your OCTO with the lighting fixture setup. If you don't know your OCTO Mark II's IP address, then you can download the free ENTTEC software EMU with the links in the description. With this software, you can discover your device and from there, it'll tell you the IP address. Otherwise, if you have just taken your OCTO Mark II out of the box and connected it to your computer without a DHCP server directly, its default IP address is 192.168.0.10. Okay, let's get started. So, step one is to select an existing pixel protocol that matches the desired pixel fixture. You need to select an output protocol that shares the same data structure and transmission method as your lights. The pixel protocol list can be categorized into three main groups: WS2812B, TM1814, and UCS8903-16-bit. WS2812B is the suggested protocol if your lighting fixture's data structure is 8-bit and RGB or RGBW and the transition method has no additional bit, D1, D2, D3, dot dot DN. TM1814 is the suggested protocol if your pixel fixture's data structure is 8-bit and RGBW and the transition method is C1, C2, D1, D2, D3, dot dot DN, with the additional 64-bit constant current value in the front. UCS8903-16-bit is the suggested protocol if your pixel fixture's data structure is 16-bit and RGB or RGBW and the transition method has no additional bit. D1, D2, D3, DN. Step 2 is to navigate to the settings page on the web interface. To access the web interface, we recommend Google Chrome, however, it does work with other browsers. Enter the IP address of your OCTO Mark II and then you'll land on the home page. From here, click on Settings, and if your lights are connected to Output 1, then change the settings for Output 1. If they're connected to Output 2, then change the Output 2. These can be set to have different output protocols if you have different lights connected to each port. Step 3 requires the data sheet because we need the bit 0 high time or TOH and bit 1 high time or T1H, overall bit time and reset time. These points are all on the data sheet, except sometimes they don't have the overall bit time, which you just have to use this formula here to calculate. All of this information can usually be found in the sequence timetable in the data sheet.
Okay, so let's get all of this information so we know what to put into the web interface for the custom protocol. For this, we recommend using the midpoint. So if the data sheet is like this one and gives us a range, then we just have to go through and find the midpoint of each of these figures, and that's what we'll be doing with this example. The first thing we need to get is the TOH time, which is 220 plus 380 divided by 2. So that means our TOH time is 300 nanoseconds. Then we need to get the T1H time, so that's 580 plus 1600 divided by 2 is 1090, so the T1H is 1090 nanoseconds. Now we need to use a formula from earlier to work out the overall bit time. So first we need to work out the lower limit, which is TOH plus TOL. The TOH lower limit is 220 nanoseconds. And the TOL lower range is 580 nanoseconds. Plus those two together and you get 800 nanoseconds. Now we need to find the upper limit. And to find the upper limit, it's T1H plus T1L. The T1H upper limit is 1600 nanoseconds plus T1L, which is 420 nanoseconds. Plus them two together and we get 2020 nanoseconds. Now we need to find the midpoint for these. So plus them together, divide by 2, and you get 1410 nanoseconds. So the overall bit time is 1410 nanoseconds. Now we need the reset time, which is above 280,000 nanoseconds. Now we need to go to the web interface, put in the correct protocol, and start customizing it. So put in the TOH, which is 300 nanoseconds, the T1H, which is 1090 nanoseconds. If you find that the T1H is higher than the default overall bit time, then the web interface will not allow you to put in the T1H time. So what you need to do is just put in the overall bit time first, and then go back and put in the T1H time, and then it'll let you. Put in the reset time. Scroll down to the bottom, click save.
Now, your OCTO Mark II should be putting out the correct protocol for your lights. Now, as promised, what to look out for if your controller is outputting the wrong protocol. You will see your lights flicker, or if they simply just do not light up, then this could be a sign of an incorrect protocol. To fix this, double check your data sheet and make sure that everything you have entered in the web interface is correct and you have connected it to the correct output, output 1 or 2. Quick tip for the OCTO Mark II, if you want to know which lights are connected to your OCTO, especially in larger projects, or if they are connected properly, then press the identify button on your OCTO. And the lights that are connected will light up white for 10 seconds. If they don't, then you know something hasn't worked properly. Thank you for watching, and if you like this video or you found it useful, please give us a thumbs up. And if you want to stay up to date with more videos like this or future unboxing live streams for new and upcoming products, then hit the subscribe button and the bell. Comment down below if you have any questions or you think there's something that we've missed. You can check out our social media pages in the links below if you want more ENTTEC content and stay tuned for more updates and more helpful ENTTEC tips.
Free software out in you, your device from there. It'll tell you, this sentence is wrong.
Is the suggested protocol if your pixel, The suggested protocol if your pixel,